Hello and welcome to Game Systems TV. My name's Steve and today we're bringing you a special E3 2016 stream. It's not a normal stream of playing games and playing Forza 6 as you see on the screen. I got this merely for something to be seen on the actual stream itself. It's merely there. Like, it's like when you watch music video, well, when you watch music on YouTube. It's a song that doesn't have a music video for it, and so it's either like a static screen of a pack of like the pack shot of the case or something like that, or someone's got some fancy flashy kind of colours going on. Yeah, it's a bit like that. It's so you can see something showing, just like I'm showing off this Nissan GTR that I have in Forza 6. But unfortunately I have to only bring you the audio for copyright reasons. I am not legally allowed to show you it, and I've tried it, trust me, and they've blocked me from showing it, but I can play it to you though. So I can play you the audio. For the parts that, basically show a video, but there's no, you know, there's just sound, there's nothing actually vocally going on, so you're not actually quite sure what is actually being shown, I will step in and will explain what is, you know, what is being shown on screen. So don't worry about that. I will inform you guys of what's going on there. If you like the stream, please feel free to follow us. If you're tuned in and hoping to see Forza 6, unfortunately, you won't. The only part of Forza 6 you'll see is what you can see on screen now. There's no audio at all. The whole audio is from the Ubisoft press conference that was last night. Or yesterday afternoon or something in America, I think it was. It was in the evening here in the UK. But before I do that, I am going to bring you some other information and other announcements that has been announced and come to light here so far with regards to what's going on in the gaming industry at the moment. That's also either yet to be announced or has been announced. The new Call of Duty Infinite Warfare trailer shows off dogfights, zero-G combat. Activision released an intense trailer for this year's shooter during the Sony E3 briefing last night. We haven't seen that yet. That will be to come. It won't be today. We will be doing that one tomorrow, as well as I will be doing a Forza Motorsport 6 stream. So don't worry about that. I will be doing the standard one. Normally, today, there wouldn't be a stream. I'm only doing this for the sake of catching up with E3 and the announcements at E3 and bringing you what I can from E3 from the publishers as well as the manufacturers such as Sony and Microsoft as well. PS4 exclusive Days Gone has ridiculously huge swarms of zombies. At Sony's E3 2016 press conference, a new apocalyptic zombie game was revealed for the PlayStation 4. So, another thing that's also been announced for PlayStation 4 and only been announced for PlayStation 4. It doesn't seem like it's coming on any other console, and also it was announced at Sony's E3 press conference. Other announcements here, I'm just checking over. That was announced at Sony's press conference was a game called Death Stranding. And it's a first look from the legendary director Hideo Kojima, who's also responsible for Metal Gear Solid. Spider-Man has also been announced for PlayStation 4. You've got Batman Arkham VR that's been announced for PlayStation 4. as well as PlayStation VR, of course. Farpoint VR, that's also coming to PlayStation VR. Call of Duty Infinite Warfare, that's no new news there. It is also been announced, and has been announced for a while. You guys know about that already. And also Call of Duty 4 Modern Warfare Remastered, they also showcased that, and that's also been announced, and you guys already know about that one. Final Fantasy 15 VR experience. Now, Final Fantasy 15 was announced at the Microsoft press conference that I played in the previous stream, so you guys already knew about that. But it's also having a VR experience and being used on PlayStation VR as well, so you can summon like you never summoned before, apparently, so they say in the game, you basically using the PlayStation VR. Crash Bandicoot is now being featured in Skylanders Imaginators. So there's a new Skylanders game that is coming out called Imaginators. Crash Bandicoot is one of the characters that will be in that game. You also got LEGO Star Wars 7, The Force Awakens. That's also coming out very soon as well. Resident Evil 7, like I mentioned at the end of the previous stream. That's something that's also has been announced that will be coming out to PlayStation 4, Xbox One, and PC, and has also been announced for PlayStation VR as well. Days Gone is also a PlayStation 4 exclusive. Star Wars Battlefront X-Wing VR has also been announced. I mean, but looking at these games that have been announced at PlayStation's or Sony's press conference, it looks like they only talking about VR games. There's hardly any games that are coming out for your PS4. So for you guys that are not really interested in VR and basically just want to stick to the old school gaming of sitting there with a controller in your hands, unfortunately you ain't going to be in much luck having a PlayStation 4 over the coming year, because Sony are basically concentrating and throwing all their money at their VR, and they have failed time and time again with these things that they keep bringing out, these little projects that they keep bringing out, and it's cost them a lot of money. Is it going to be the same with the PlayStation VR? I mean, the VR spec has been around for a few years now and has been announced a few years. This year is definitely coming into full swing, and most of them will be released this year. But, I mean, will the hype die off quickly? You never know. Will Sony make their money on this and make even more profit on it? You don't know. I mean, if you take Google Glass, for example, everyone hyped up about that. Loads of people bought it. As of 2016, it is pretty much dead. I mean, how many people still have a Google Glass? How many people use it? How many people have updated new stuff for Google Glass? I think Google has pretty much given up on it. So it could be an overhyped technology like Google Glass. So we'll have to wait and see how the next year pans out for the VR. So once it's released, we give it a year, see how it pans out, will it take off, or it won't take off. I mean, me myself, I do want to check it out, at least try it out myself, but I'm not really looking at the PlayStation VR. One, I don't have a PS4 myself, and we don't have a PS4 in the office here either, but I like the Oculus Rift more, because the game's for it, more than the PlayStation VR. We'll have to wait and see. If I do get a PlayStation 4, I will maybe check out the PS VR as well. So we'll wait and see. Detroit Become Human has also been announced, and Horizon Zero Dawn has actually finally been given its release date, which is this year. The Last Guardian is also was announced last year, mainly announced last year. But also got more intense kind of gameplay to it in this year's E3. Now, this is a stream and a press conference that we will be bringing you in the next stream, so you get to see that in the stream to come. At the moment, we're mainly concentrating on Ubisoft's press conference. That's what it says in the description, and that's what we're basically here for at the moment, and what we'll be playing for you over the next couple of hours. So, in order to not make you wait any longer, and for me not to babble on anymore with regards to what's going on, and obviously Ubisoft's press conference as well, I am going to bring to you Ubisoft's E3 2016 press conference. Here we go.
Confusing and awesome. And my mom has those boots, by the way. She wants them back. Ladies and gentlemen, you know when you see a dancing crab and a baby bird with a paper collar that you could only be at the Ubisoft E3 press conference. Welcome. Welcome. Dancers, can you guys bring it in behind me for a second? Just gather around. Get behind me here. It's a special year, and I want to take a moment to do something that's gonna feel a little incongruous and potentially even uncomfortable for some of you. There's no smooth or easy way to do this, but we all felt really strongly when we were rehearsing today that we needed to say this. So before we start, everyone here at Ubisoft want to offer our deepest sympathies to the people affected by this weekend's tragedy in Orlando. Our hearts, the hearts of everyone in Paris, in France, in the United States, and around the world are with you. And now, with a human giraffe on my right and a candy cane on my left, I'm going to make a very hard right turn and get into the fun stuff. Thanks for coming on, guys. Dance away. Dance away. The madness that you just saw was courtesy of the Movement Wizards at Just Dance 2017. Just Dance has always been at the forefront of innovation, bringing its experience to new devices and also introducing the world to the first dance on demand streaming service with Just Dance Unlimited. And today, Ubisoft is pleased to announce that Just Dance 2017 will be coming to all video game platforms and PC in October and to the Nintendo NX next year. Yes. Your life is not complete until you have a lion singing at you out of your television screen. Hello and welcome to everybody lucky enough to be sitting here in this theater and even luckier enough to be watching at home around the globe because you have snacks and you probably didn't shower today. I am Aisha Tyler. Some of you probably didn't shower either. There's no judgment here. I am Aisha Tyler and I'm standing in the historic Orpheum Theater in vaguely beautiful yet faintly urine-scented downtown Los Angeles. It's true, right? It's underneath everything. And the badges are on everyone's necks and the smiles on everyone's faces can only mean one thing. It is E3 conference time. Now, 2016 is a huge year for everyone here at Ubisoft. It's my fifth time hosting this conference. Yes. And you all know what the traditional gift is for a fifth anniversary, yeah? That's right, my friends. Wood. Or girl wood, if you choose. Let it wash over you. Now, they always ask me, like, why do I continue to do this conference in the face of the overwhelming internet love that I receive? And it's not the money, I'll tell you that. Ubisoft is French. They're paying me in red wine and sarcasm, you guys. No, I come back every year because I love games. I play these games, I adore them, and I love being a part of the excitement that comes with revealing new games to the world. Every day, every year when I do this, I'm like a kid in a candy store. A really large, slightly masculine kid in a candy store. And speaking of excitement, it's Ubisoft's 30th birthday. Yeah, give it up for Ubi. Or Ubi. Ubi may be 30, but like everyone aged weekdays and dresses, but whatever makes it feel good. Now, over these three decades, Ubisoft has been flexing its creative muscles, giving its teams the freedom to push boundaries and create games that are memorable, fun, and sometimes a little crazy. So, enough talk. We're going to hit fast forward right now and get straight to the games. All right? Now, you may remember our next title from the end of last year's show, when it blew your fucking mind. And if you're at home playing a drinking game, yes, an F-bomb in the first 5 minutes of this show. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Ghost Recon Wildlands.
In Bolivia, the coca leaf is core to the culture. It's found in every gas station, every hospital, and every town square. And they use it for a variety of things, like treating nausea and altitude sickness, to a refreshing energy drink. But it can also be used to make cocaine. So we asked, what if? What if a Mexican drug cartel moved in, took over the entire country, seized all of those coca resources to become the number one producer of cocaine on the planet, effectively turning Bolivia into a narco state? This is the world of Ghost Recon Wildlands. And you? Well, you're the ghosts. The elite spec ops drop deep behind enemy lines to create chaos and disrupt the alliance between a corrupt local government and the Santa Blanca cartel, ultimately going after their leader, the vicious El Sueño. Hi, everybody. My name is Dominic Butler. I'm the lead game designer for Ghost Recon Wildlands. Ghost Recon Wildlands is the very first military shooter set in a massive, dangerous open world that you can play entirely in solo or in up to four-player co-op. With beautiful environments set across a variety of different ecosystems that will challenge and influence your gameplay at every step of the way, all of this takes place in the largest action-adventure open world Ubisoft has ever done. Now, in the gameplay we're about to show you, the ghosts already have a target. His name is El Pozolero. He's known as the Stew Maker because he makes the bodies disappear. Now, the ghosts know that their target is in a large Santa Blanca camp somewhere in the San Mateo province, but they don't know where yet exactly. And because Ghost Recon Wildlands gives you the total freedom of choice to do what you want, when you want, we put the power back in the player's hands to achieve their objectives their way. In this case, the ghosts know that their target has some vital intel. They want to take him alive, so they've opted for a tactical extraction. Let's go get that intel.
The intel we need is supposed to be in this Sicario's house. Looks like it's upstairs.
Copy that.
Need any help?
Nah, I got this.
Okay, I'll take a look around.
Right, let's try to keep it stealthy.
Well, we just tuned in. Thanks ever so much for tuning in to Game Systems TV. Currently, we are showcasing the Ubisoft conference at E3 2016. Basically, just playing the audio, because obviously we... For legal reasons, we can't show you the visual. And that's a bit of a shame. I have tried, and I've tried ways of getting around this this copyright legality. But unfortunately, I can't. Right. And the system also won't let me. The Xbox won't let me do it. So, unfortunately, I have to only just bring you the audio.
Okay, I got the
if you wonder what's going on at right now, Ubisoft are showcasing what's going on with Ghost Recon Wildlands. They're just showing the gameplay of the game and also about how to get that intel, like you said before the video. They're basically just showcasing off and going into a building, getting some intel. Also, that he's just got onto a helicopter, and he's flying on the helicopter, ready to shoot.
There's a camp. Oh, damn, this one's gonna be tough.
Yeah, we could definitely use some backup on this one.
Hey, you guys need a hand? Right on time. We're going after El Pozolero. We're at the east of the San Mateo base.
Got it. We are on our way.
Well, he's just landed, and him and his comrades are running across a desert kind of terrain alongside tracks. There's also another player in like an off-road buggy that is also assisting him.
He's
also coming along. But yeah, the terrain is set in, seems to be like a desert-y kind of setting with
Looks like a whole lot of trouble.
Bushes and little bits of shrubbery as well. And obviously he's just scoping out
one less to worry about.
People that are on watchtowers.
Weaver, can you get to a good sniper position on the south side of the camp?
No problem.
To take them out.
Alrighty, I'm moving in from the other side.
Copy that. Infiltrate. We're moving in from the train station at the east end of the camp. Buildings in order to get that intel. Right. Going to move on then. I'm going to head back to the Ubisoft conference and head back to the gameplay of Ghost Recon.
I got eyes on a sniper.
Wait for my signal.
Got it. Now, tango down. Let's move. Okay, wait a minute. I hear something inside. Two guys. I got the one on the right. You ready?
Ready.
Go.
Good job.
Okay, I'm gonna deploy the drone and see what's up ahead. Looks like an old town that Santa Blanca's turned into a base. Oh man, there are guards all over the place.
That bad? Yep, be careful.
One down, so far so good.
Got my way in, guys.
Alright, let's see what's in this big building. Okay, I got him. Red gloves, gas mask. He's got guards with him.
Got it. And another one down. I'm moving through.
Gotcha. Okay, I'm close to the building. Try to find a way in. You saw anything else?
Oh man, I think he was dissolving somebody.
Like in a can of acid or something.
Yeah, looked pretty nasty.
Come on guys, let's move.
All right. I think I found my spot, nearly there.
Careful, there's more of them the closer you get.
Only one left. Okay, I'm in position.
I have three tangos in front of me. Weaver, you think you can help?
I got it.
Going in.
Don't let this guy get away.
I see him. We'll talk about nightmare fuel.
Call us if you need us.
Don't worry, man. I got this. Shit! You spotted me! Guys, I'm spotted! El Pozolero's running. Going after him. Where is he? Get out of the way, man! He's in a white SUV heading for the east end of the camp. Following on a bike.
Got it. I'm moving to intercept.
This camp's on full alert, guys. We need to get out of here fast.
Shit! Hulk, get in the car!
Where is he?
Shit, no, he's moving too fast. Go the other way. Come on, man. Let's go.
Hurry up. The gate's closing.
I'm right behind you. Weaver, are you okay?
I'm good.
Frag out.
I'm pulling out. Found a bike, guys. I'm on my way.
Hey, watch your fire. We need him alive.
I can't get a good shot.
This guy's all over the place.
Stop moving.
Okay, guys, I'm clear. Out of the camp, on the road. Where are you guys? Let me know you're... Damn, the whole place is going up. All right, I'm heading for the chopper now.
Damn, he's trying to ram the car. I gotta hit his engine.
No, I'm trying to slow him down.
Help is on the way, guys. I'll run this train. Where's the chopper? Where is it? I found it. Okay, getting in. I'm in the chopper, coming your way. All right, I'm on my way, guys. Hang tight.
Oh, no. He's not stopping. Oh, man, come on. I'm trying.
He's a tough one, this guy, huh?
Oh! We're not gonna push him off.
Looks like he's losing control.
Can you push him to the side?
I don't know how it looks up there, but that's what I'm trying to do.
Ugh. dodged it.
Hang on, guys. I'm nearly there.
Oh, damn it. Okay, I got him.
Yes, he stopped.
I'll get him. Be careful.
Ride's here.
Out you get, buddy.
Hurry up, we got cartel reinforcements incoming.
Up you get, and in you go.
Adios, let's get the hell out of here.
I got him in my line of fire.
Well, hold him off, I gotta fly this thing.
And
we are clear, gentlemen.
Nice work.
That was a tough mission.
Oh man, that was close.
Head over to GhostRecon.com right now for all the latest news and gameplay videos. For those of you here at E3, please come by the booth. We've got 4-player co-op demos, and we would love for you to try it. We want to get your feedback. Ghost Recon Wildlands will be released on March 7th, 2017. Thank you. Have a great show.
States is escalating at an alarming pace. The statistics are staggering. Urban centers are oversaturated with violence. And the wave of criminal activity has overflowed suburban and rural areas. Dissolution of moral structure, international conspiracies, a multi-billion dollar drug trade. No one knows the source, and authorities are helpless in stopping this epidemic of crime. Civilization is being pushed to the brink. To stem the rising tide of violence and re-establish order, extreme steps must be taken. The question becomes, who will take them?
Team put together a trailer. We just took some stuff from Snowdrop and said, make cool trailer, and that's what it puts out. So that's kind of the way that goes. But all that chaos, all that scary stuff is totally true. Thankfully, the Coon is up to the occasion. And who better to defend the town of South Park and really Colorado and really the world than superheroes or kids in superhero costumes? So, like the Coon, I need some help from some friends. Please welcome Trey Parker and Matt Stone.
Couch. This
yeah.
is sweet.
I had it
finally,
brought in.
Sit down.
I know, it was an exhausting walk all the way to there. So let's talk about the story. Everybody wants to know what's going on in the Fractured But Whole.
Don't know yet.
Yeah.
Pretty soon. It
picks up where the Stick of Truth kind of left off. You're the new kid. If you played Stick of Truth, you would know that in it, you're the new kid who moved to South Park. And so the game's really about who you are, and you kind of define who you are in South Park, but whereas The Stick of Truth was like a fantasy send-up, and you end up being the king in the end, and it's like the next day in South Park, and the kids have sort of switched up, and now they're playing superheroes.
Right.
Right?
Yeah, and so we actually have a backstory that the kids have been playing superhero, but they got into a big fight about something, so they're in the Civil War. Yep. Part of their
kind of civil war.
And in fact, Marvel wanted to call their movie Captain America the Fractured But Whole, but we had already taken that name. So they had to call their Civil War.
It's a true story. That's extremely true.
But also, we want to get into who you are as this new kid and the fact that, you know, in Stick of Truth you really rose to being cool because you became king, but in this game they've kind of switched games and so you're back to being a douchebag again.
Right, so let's see how that douchebag was able to make it into Coon and Friends. Real gameplay.
Dude, what the fuck? Who's that Listen, bro, we are all superheroes and you aren't, so you can't hang out with us. Please do us all a solid and fuck off. We should be adding people to ours. This dork, like, wearing a little crown? Does this look like a superhero to you? All right, have a seat, douchebag. Not there. That's Mysterion's seat. Not there either, stupid. All right, in order to play superheroes, you have to have a superhero persona. Then you can fill out your character sheet on Kunstagram. Do you have a Kunstagram page? Oh boy, you're not even on Kunstagram, huh? Well, I guess I can create one for you. Fucking unbelievable. Let's see. So the first thing we need to fill out on your character sheet is your class. You know, what kind of superhero are you? Feature, yes, like the Flash or Quicksilver. I like it.
Yes, wow.
Ooh,
that's what I'm thinking.
It was really important to us to be able to, and you guys, to be able to really create your own superhero. So that you saw on that UI that there are a dozen different superhero classes you can choose from. You mix and match powers from those classes and really make a superhero all your own. But what else is new in the Fractured But Whole?
That's obviously, it's definitely more of a, there's definitely more of defining your character and kind of, in superhero movies, there's always like the intense emotional center that like motivates why you have to go out and fight crime. So it's a much, as you can already tell, it's a much more spiritual.
It's a more spiritual.
It's more spiritual game. It's right. Much more about.
It's like there's actually a part of it that I'm really proud of where there's a gay fish in South Park and he loves fish sticks and the gay fish actually wants you to help him get his mother into heaven. And so you get to journey up and try to help this little gay fish get his mom into heaven. And you're all acting like this shit's regular.
Shit is hard.
This shit is hard.
It was
hard. Those are...
I hope you all saw the Kanye thing.
You didn't see the Kanye thing, that won't make it. No,
okay. But Cartman's the one who's kind of in charge of telling each superhero what their tragic backstory was that right. made them a superhero, and so this is what he comes up with for the player.
Right, let's see it.
Who let this guy join us anyway? Go easy on him, you guys. He's had a tough life, and it's time they learned your tragic backstory. You lay awake that night, like so many other nights. You couldn't sleep because you knew you weren't like the other kids. You walked to the mirror. You looked in the mirror and you felt alone, and that's when it happened. A loud noise. You swore you could hear your mother calling for help. You left your
room. Just tuned in. Thanks ever so much for tuning in to Game Systems TV. As it says in the description, we are showcasing off a Ubisoft press conference from E3 2016 yesterday. If you didn't see it, obviously we can't show you it in pictures because we're not allowed to for copyright reasons. But we are bringing you the audio so you got the gist of actually what was going on and also announcements as well that happened during the conference. Currently, they're showing the new South Park game, the Fractured Butthole. And basically just showing through some just gameplay of the characters. Now the characters are all dressed in like their own kind of superhero kind of way and having a bit of a conversation as you kind of hear in the background.
Our dad fucked our moms. Oh, right. So does that mean your dad fucked your mom, Cam? Huh? Yes, my dad fucked my mom. That's why I'm here. Don't steal his backstory, dude. That's not cool.
And there you go. There is part of the Fractured Butthole from South Park. Now back to the Ubisoft press conference.
To that story.
Yeah, it's very personal for us, and apparently that does touch a lot of people.
There's very few people that can at least relate to it at some level, except for Jesus. So, I got that one out. So obviously that's pretty brutal. We've got another thing in South Park that's brutal, our combat, and we worked on that a lot together.
Yeah, the combat system is much improved from Stick of Truth.
Also, please get involved in the chat as well. We'd love to hear your feedback from you guys as to what your thoughts are from the announcements from Ubisoft's press conference. So, from our showcase, if you've got anything you want to say or anything you want to ask, what's going on, or questions wise, or if there's anything you want to talk about within the chat, please feel free to get involved in the chat. If you guys are watching this on YouTube, please feel free also to let us know your comments in the comment section of this video.
What we ended up putting in is they'll combat space and time. So let's talk about it. First, let's talk about space. You're not restricted to a location anymore. Now you can move to get into tactical positions on your enemies. Ooh. You can also move to get behind cover. You can push and pull enemies, but they can also do it to you. You can knock them into props and get a little extra damage. You can knock them into other characters and get an extra attack. You can use some of your powers like Tweak here to get over obstacles. So obviously using space makes a big difference. Farts were legendary. Now your farts are so powerful that you can use them to rip the fabric of time itself.
Like Ghost Recon.
So, you can use that to rearrange the turn order. Mastering space and time makes a huge difference. I can't wait for you guys to get your hands on it. Let's bring it out with big volume. To work on, and I think both of our teams have been having a ton of fun, and we're almost done, and now we have some exciting news for our South Park fans before we go. Anyone who buys the Fractured But Whole will get the Stick of Truth for PS4, Xbox One, and Steam for free. If you pre-purchase the game today, Fractured But Whole, that is, and you can start playing Stick of Truth right away. So check out our website and for information and about our participating retailers. Right?
Yeah.
Cool.
That was great.
You don't want to.
So,
do
we made a trailer if you want to see it.
Yeah.
Sort of shows what the boys are fighting about that was the Civil War Fractured But Whole part of
people
it.
People want to know the release date, probably, too.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
what
do you think
release
date?
I'm putting my money on December 6th. The Fractured But Whole will be released on December 6th. Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Right,
thank you.
Thanks,
everybody.
Thanks.
Enjoy the trailer. Why did we choose this life? Why did we become superheroes? We dedicate our lives to fighting crime for one reason. To make $1 billion on a superhero franchise. Now let's go through the plan one more time. First, we start with a Coon movie. Then we do the Super Craig movie. Then Super Craig and Coon will join forces in the Human Kite movie just as we start ramping up Kenny's Netflix series. How come I have to have the Netflix series? I want a movie too. You have a movie, Mysterion. You're in the third Coon and Friends United movie after your Netflix series.
Yeah, but he's saying he doesn't ever get his own movie.
Do I get my own movie? Not everyone gets their own movie.
The franchise plan sucks. If we want to make billions of dollars, then I think we should start with the Tupperware movie.
Right, start with a black superhero.
Marvel is making a black superhero movie.
Yeah, now! They waited years to get to that! We follow their plan, we do all the real people first, and we sneak the black guy in Phase 3.
How about we just do movies starring all of us, like all the time? But then we're just rehashing the same old material!
There's nothing wrong with doing the exact same movie to start a franchise!
Okay, J.J. Abrams.
Okay, so you're on Cartman's side?
He just likes this plan because he gets two movies in Phase 1.
God! We have to just go with this plan! We don't even have one movie yet!
How did it get to this? How did we grow so far apart?
You go with the plan. Maybe we'll just go and do our own franchise.
Yeah.
Yeah! Oh, you want Civil War? Is that what you want? Yeah, dude, Civil War. Fuck you. Fuck you! Get out of my house!
We'll make way more money on our franchise.
Go ahead. I bet you don't even get halfway through phase one on your franchise, DC Comics.
I thought Civil War wasn't supposed to happen until phase three.
Shut up, Super Craig.
I didn't want to have to do this, but you leave me no choice.
Did I just hear someone use a macroaggression?
If you have been playing that drinking game at home, you probably fell asleep on your computer. And now we move from the flatulent, prepubescent superheroes of South Park to the snowy, post-pandemic streets of New York in Tom Clancy's The Division. Thanks to all of you out there, The Division broke records when it launched earlier this year, and today more than 10 million of you have spent up to 3 hours a day hitting a steady supply of high-value targets and trying to get your hands on the best loot in the Dark Zone. Well, here to tell us more about what's new in The Division, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Julian Garrity, creative director from Massive Entertainment.
Thank you. And thank you for wearing those shoes.
I like to make everybody feel...
I'm not actually that short.
No. You're actually taller than me without these shoes on. I'm sorry.
I'll go with it. And thanks to all the Division players out there who are so passionate about our game.
Yeah. It's a cool-ass game. And you guys have been adding all kinds of new stuff to the game since it debuted. We heard just a little while ago about the Underground, so do you want to tell us more about what's going on with
Absolutely.
That?
Absolutely. So, in Underground, you and your team will be fighting against a dangerous threat hidden beneath the streets of New York City. And every time you play, the challenge is unique. That means endless replayability and even better rewards the further you go.
Okay, so, I mean, one of the coolest things about this game is it is open world, it is so robust, and you're making it more robust all the time. So are you going to tell us when we're going to get this new content, or do I just have to start taking bets? I know, I'm big and I'm also pushy.
Yes.
I agree.
Underground will be out June 28th on Xbox One and PC and August 2nd on PS4. And this is just one of the updates we'll be releasing this year. Because for the Division team, this is a long-term commitment. We love this world, you love this world, and we're going to keep on making it better for you.
That's awesome. I mean, you know I've been in love with this game since you guys first debuted it. On one of the shows that I hosted, and I'm really, really excited about it.
Cool. And that's not the only thing we're going to tell you about today. Mm-hmm. We've got a little surprise for you. To celebrate Ubisoft's 30th birthday, three outfits to use in Ghost Recon, Rainbow Six, and Splinter Cell. You get an outfit. You get an outfit. Chad, you get the three outfits. Good for you, Chad. So, if you're a member of Ubisoft Club, all of these outfits will be three for you with the release of Underground.
It's like smushing two or three or four games together that you love.
Don't tell the other teams.
I don't know. I have a lot of feelings.
They let us do this.
But I love it. Well, I'm super stoked about running around Manhattan in trifocal goggles without getting arrested like I typically do. So we've got Underground. We've got dope new outfits. More?
We've got one more expansion to talk to you about today. In it, you'll struggle to find meager supplies in New York and fight to survive in some of the most brutal weather conditions imaginable. It's a completely new way of playing the game, and you'll be able to play it very soon. Even sooner if you're on Xbox One or PC. Ladies and gentlemen, this is survival.
Yeah.
Blizzard was getting worse, but we had to investigate the rumors of a cure.
tuning in to Game Systems TV. Thanks ever so much for tuning in to Game Systems TV. We are currently showcasing off the Ubisoft press conference from E3 2016 that was broadcasted yesterday. It was at 2:30 p.m. there in the afternoon Pacific time. Here in the UK, it was 5:30. No, one. Well, it was 8:30, so I was picking up the Microsoft one. No, it's 8:30 here in the UK. Currently, they're showcasing off what appears to look like a new Splinter Cell game. I don't know if 100% if that's correct. But basically, it looks like Fish is being shot at and he's running down the street being shot at. It's either Splinter Cell or Division. I think it's the Division, to be honest. I might have got that wrong. Ignore me. But I will tell you at the end of the trailer, obviously, what game it actually is.
The storm doesn't care if you live or die.
Now, obviously, he was just about to be shot at, was taken hostage, but now he's been helped up by
some of us
fellow comrades. It appears to be the Division, and it's called the Survival Expansion. Now, back to the Ubisoft press conference, Ubisoft showcase from E3 2016.
Awesomeness. Now, for Ubisoft, VR is the perfect technology for making gaming more accessible. And Ubisoft Montreal's Funhouse team built a game that just about everyone is going to know how to play the minute they put on their headsets. So, here to take us into the world of Eagle Flight, please welcome creative director Xiao Huto, along with two huge fans of the game, Palmer Luckey, inventor and founder of Oculus, and Jason Holtman, head of publishing at Oculus VR.
I am very excited to show you the game today, and even more excited to have you guys to play with us.
Thanks for having us. We're huge fans of Eagle Flight. It's a very, very intuitive game, and the flight mechanic is super innovative, and it gives you that real freedom of flying in VR. But most of all, it's just super fun, and by super fun, I mean I can beat Palmer almost every time I play.
That's not true. But I mean, we've been playing this game for months at Oculus, and we've been getting pretty good at it. And so this is a really good chance for us to come and show everybody that we can beat you guys at your own game.
Yeah. Let's see what you've got, Palmer.
Let's go.
Hello, everyone. My name's Carsten Myhill, and I'm going to talk you through, for the first time ever at E3, a live PvP demo in VR. It's called Capture the Prey. And two teams of three will battle it out in the skies over Paris. Over here, we have the blue team, resplendent in their Hawaiian shirts, led by Palmer Luckey, Olivier, and Vicky. And the red team, led by Jason Holtman, with his two wingmen, Andre and Charlie. The rules are simple. It's a capture the flag game. And we will play best of three. So if we're ready to go, let's fly. So we can see the first location of the prey, right there at the foot of the Eiffel Tower, and they have to take it to the nest to score a point. It's a bit like football, they have to work as a team, taking the object and bringing it to a goal. All right, maybe not the greatest analogy in the world, but you get the idea. Teamwork is key to succeeding in this game. Paris has been reclaimed by nature. We can see the Champ de Mars overrun now with beautiful trees and undergrowth, and nature, and escaped animals from the zoo, like those giraffes over there. Olivier has the rabbit, and is making his way over to the nest right now. He's trying to stay low, using shortcuts, weaving in and out of the trees, taking little alleyways and tunnels wherever he can, trying to stay out of sight of his opponents who are trying to shoot him. Oh, and he's been hit by Andre. And the rabbit is down. Charlie's got it. So the red team in possession.
Oh
no. By Vicky. Who's going to pick it up? They're not far from the nest now. And it's Olivier for the blue team.
Yeah!
There's the nest. Are blue going to score first? Yes, they are. 1-0 to the blue team. Yeah, well done, guys. Okay, remember, it's best of three, so the red team need to score to stay in the contest. Oh, Vicky with the amazing steal and then flew right into the line of sight of Andre, who took it from her. Into the tunnels, utilising gusts of winds and thermals to get a speed boost. Andre looks like he's got a bit of a free run at the moment. Someone's shooting at him though. Andre staying low, Jason being wingman, backing him up. Over to the Pantheon there. Oh, great kill by Jason on Olivier. Oh, no! But Andre has it for the red team. 1-1. Well done. Don't high-five each other. That's not going to work. Okay, the final location is right there at the top of the Eiffel Tower. Don't ask me how the rabbit got up there. It's an extremely exposed position. We'll see them shooting at each other as they head up to try and get that final rabbit to win the game.
Yeah!
Palmer with a kill, good work. And Andre's down, great shot of Vicky taking him out there. Vicky inside the Eiffel Tower, utilising the thermals. But Jason with the rabbit gets the final score, no! Vicky with the steal. Okay, we have to chase on to get to that final nest. Not far to go now. Andre with it for the red team. Taken out just at the final moment. And the blue team with the steal right at the end to win the game. Well done, blue team. Keep on playing. Sorry guys, you're going to have to stop now. For those of you here, you can come to the Ubisoft booth and the Oculus booth to try it out yourselves. So we'd love to come and see you down there. Thanks very much. Have a great E3.
All right. Thanks to Palmer and Jason, Charlie, and of course the entire dev team. I actually got to play an early version of this game last year at E3, and I'm not going to lie to you, it was like super alpha, and I peed a little. Like, it wasn't even very good, and it was awesome. So this is going to be incredible. I really encourage you to check it out. Eagle Flight is going to be on Oculus Rift and all the other VR platforms this fall, and it is playable this week at the Ubisoft and Oculus booth, so get down there and do it. Now that we've seen some flying raptors soaring through abandoned city streets, it's time to ascend a bit higher in elevation. So please welcome Ubisoft Red Storm's David Votivka.
At Ubisoft, VR is about more than just technology. It's about creating games that just weren't possible before. And exploring new worlds with friends without ever having to leave your living room. It's about fully immersing yourself in these worlds and going places and becoming people and doing things that you otherwise could not do. Today, VR is all about opening up the final frontier.